Hello! In this episode, we are going to take a look at my 2CV again. It has been acting a bit stupid lately. It's out here. I'm very disappointed with it. Yeah. It's left me stranded twice this week. Not stranded really, because I always carry a bit of tools. And the problem has been that I drove the fuel tank very low the other day, actually when I was going to the MOT with the trailer, and because of that I think, which is a pretty common thing on old cars, I sucked in all the dirt and rust and crap from the bottom of the fuel tank. A good advice is, one thing is to clean your fuel tank, but if you don't want to do that because it's quite messy and boring, don't drive it completely empty, because it will just suck up all the dust and crap from the bottom. So, but I did that anyway, and that has left me with this problem that the I think it's the needle valve in the carb that gets clogged, because sometimes it just cuts out and I can't get it to run. Then I open up the top of the carb and discover that it's completely empty for fuel in the ball. Then mess around a bit with the needle valve and then plug it all back together and run it. Each time it happened, I tested the fuel pump as the first thing, because it could have been that as well, but it seems to be working perfect. So I think the needle valve is being stupid, or maybe for some reason the flow is hanging. Inside the car, as you can see, there's no fuel in the fuel bulb. I just messed around a bit with it, and then I hope I can drive it home again. And we're now trying to go home, and it's very, very bad, the problem. Luckily for me, it's going downhill, so even though I put the throttle completely, nothing happens. Hopefully I can build enough pressure to just swing it around the corner at my garage. Let's see. Got it in almost. I have always had a problem with this car, with the carb. I can't seem to adjust anything on the mixture screw. Nothing happens. I think it's called the CO2 screw actually on this one. I cannot adjust it. Luckily it went to the MOT, but I couldn't adjust it if I had to. So I have gotten hold of another carb. This is the screw that I was talking about. You turn it in and out and adjust the idle CO2 level. And it's not doing a thing in mine. So what I'm going to do is to clean up this one. This one should be working. Back in maybe the previous millennium. But anyway, it should have been working back then. But what I'm going to do is to clean it up. And then I'm going to put all the nozzles and stuff from my Burton kit, which is on the carb out here right now, into this one, and then fit it all back together. And my 2CV should be working again. But, the first step I'm going to do right now is to remove the complete carb assembly. And I'm fairly certain that I have shown that once before. I'm not really sure, but just to recap, it's just removing the two bolts down there and on the back side as well. They're quite hard to get at, but you can do it. Just use an open end spanner, which is a bit thin, and a lot of patience. Then I'm going to take off the fuel line, the choke line, and the accelerator cable, and then I can take it out. And then we're going to see, just for the fun of it, if we can find anything wrong with the inlet, what's it called, the needle valve, or the float. But anyway, we're going to change the carb. I just want to add that it's not necessary at all to change your carb if you have a problem like this. Not at all. It's just a malfunctioning component within the carb, not the carb itself. But I have problems with this carb that I can't seem to get fixed. I think something is clogged in the air passages in there, and I cannot get it unclogged. So I'm going to change it. I will take you back when I got the carb on the tape. And I have removed the carb now. I lied before. I had to remove this one, the breather hose, the breather pipe and oil filler assembly, to get to the last bolt. I think I have done it once before without doing that, but it seemed to be completely impossible. So yeah, that is now just how it is. I will make a small time lapse of me removing everything from this one, and I'm going to grab the cameras if anything weird comes up. So yeah. Apparently I can't really find anything wrong with this one. I know I've changed this not long ago, and maybe the quality is just not that very good. So I'm just gonna check the old one on the old new carb, and I think I might just gonna reuse that one. The float assembly seems to be fine. Another thing I was thinking about was that maybe it was scratching the surface on the inside here and hanging, so it wouldn't fall down. And that is a possibility. Actually, I think that's a very good possibility. Take a look at that. Take a look at that stripe right there. I believe that the float ball, which sits like this on top of here, of course, when it's all the way up, the valve is supposed to close, and that works. But when you use the fuel, it should float with the fuel level down and open up the valve and then fill it up again. But if this side, which it seems to have been done doing over here, has been dragging on the edge because it was too far this way, then it would maybe hang right there, even though the fuel level drops, and then it will not let any new fuel in. So I do not believe that the valve itself, I do not believe that the valve itself is at fault. I believe that the float valve is the problem, and actually it's maybe just a matter of bending it a bit inwards, then it would be not happening anymore. This also explains why I could hammer on the top of here with the wheel lock nut thingy, and then it just fell down again. Maybe I really think that's the case, because that is, I hope it shows on the camera, but there are dragging marks right there. So I think we have found the fault with this, even though we're going to change it anyway because of other problems. But it's always nice to find problems and not just change parts. So now continue on cleaning the old new carburetor, which is very, very grimy and dirty. much as I want to. There's no reason to really get it any more clean than this, on the outside at least. The inside needs to be pretty clean. I'm going to begin changing all the nozzles and stuff. And I'm just going to do that time-lapse way also. Let's see, the carb is back in, everything is wired up. Well, I haven't touched any wires, but the carb is on, this one is back on, the fuel pipe. So let's try to start it. And it will not start right away because the float valve is completely empty. So it will have to pump up a bit before anything happens, but let's see. Give it a bit gas right now, then I think it will fire up. It should come now, unless something's wrong. Let's take it for a ride and see if it clears out. little test drive and it's working perfect. It got a very, very low idle at the moment, and I have adjusted it a bit up, but I will just let it bed in for a bit, because even though I cleaned it, it could have some, there could be some gummed up petrol in the small channels and all that. So I think it would be a good idea to wait with the fine adjustment to, until in a couple of weeks or something like that. But it goes fine and it pulls fine. Yeah, and everything is good. So I parked it out there again. And I think it's time to open the door again. Beautiful car. See you next time.